Hello students, in the previous lecture we have learned about the types of the matter. At normal temperature the matter is classified into mainly three types, that is solid, liquid and gaseous. In these three types we know the difference between the three types and in these three types how the particles are there. In solid the particles are closely packed with each other with a very less space between them. In liquid, the space is comparatively more, and in gaseous, the space between the particle is maximum. So, depending on the particle, characteristic of particles, this matter is classified. Now, the question is, can matter change their state? Can we change the state of the matter from one state to the other? Yes, we can change it. The best example is that we are solidifying water to ice, right? So how we are changing the matter from solid to liquid or liquid to gaseous? By changing the temperature. So what is the effect of temperature on the state of matter? Very simple. We are very much aware of this. See, so when the solid is heated, then we are heating the solid state. This delta shows the heating. So solid is heated, the solid melts and converts into liquid state. So yes, we can change the state. And when liquid is heated, it is converting, it will convert into gaseous state. But and the process of converting from solid to liquid is called melting process or also fusion. So here solid, by heating the solid state convert into liquid state, and this process is called melting. But this process, how the question is, why the solid convert into liquid by heating? Understand the arrangement of particles. In solid the particles are closely packed with each other with a definite arrangement. Here the and we are knowing the characteristic of particles, that particles are moving continuously. It means that particles are in solid, the particles are fixed on their position. Then how can they move? If they are fixed on their position, how can they move? They are not moving like in air particles, but they are moving on their places. How? They are vibrating on their places. By vibration, we can mean that the motion of pendulum, or it is an oscillatory motion. So same way, the particles of the solid are vibrating on their places. They are oscillating on their places. So this motion is seen in the solid particles. And if you know about some of the types of energy, kinetic energy, it is that when the particle, when the thing, when the object is having the energy due to its motion, it is called kinetic energy. So here the solid particles are moving. So with this motion, with this moving, these particles of solid are having some energy. So this energy due to the motion, due to this vibrating motion, they have kinetic energy. So here we can see that the solid particles are having kinetic energy because they are moving. If the motion stops, kinetic energy becomes zero. But at any temperature, here at normal temperature, at any temperature, this motion is continuing. So solid particles have kinetic energy. So in they are having some minimum having some kinetic energy. Now this solid particles are heated. It means we are giving heat energy to this particle. Already they have some kinetic energy, and again we are giving some heat energy to it, right? So the energy and this amount of energy given to this solid, this heat energy will be distributed among each particle in the solid, right? If there are millions of particles in the solid, so this heat energy will be distributed among these particles. So the energy of the particle increases. So, as they are getting more energy, they vibrate with more energy, right? So, this heat energy given to the solid particles the solid particles are moving with more speed. Okay, so the kinetic, we can say that the kinetic energy of the particle increases. And if they are vibrating with more speed, very energetically, this due to this high vibrations, the particles are going away from each other. Or we can say that the attraction force between the solid particles slightly decreases. So these particles are going away from each other, and due to this, the distance between the solid particles increases. And as the distance increases, we can say that if the distance is more enough, it will be a liquid state. So this solid state, as the particles are going away, they are converting into a the solid state is converting into the liquid state. So simple mechanism, by giving the heat energy, the kinetic energy of the particle increases, and due to this high energy, the particles are moving with more vibrations and they are going away from each other, and it will convert into liquid state. So this is how solid will convert into liquid. This is the actual mechanism of converting one state to the other. Similarly, when liquid is heated to gaseous state, liquid is heated, same way, they have some kinetic energy and vibrating in the liquid state. But when they are given some heat energy, the particles are moving with more energy and they are going away from each other. Okay, so the distance between the particle increases and it will convert into gaseous state. So this is how the state of the matter changes. And when gaseous, and if we go inversely, that means if gas is cooled, okay, it will convert into liquid, because by cooling the particles are condensed. We can say that it is condensed. It is coming closer to each other. So gaseous particles coming closer, it will convert into liquid state. And if liquid is cooled, right, the temperature of the liquid state decreases. This liquid particles coming closer to each other, and it will convert into solid state. So by this is the effect of temperature on the states of the matter. But when understand here, when solid converts into liquid, simply when we start heating the solid, simply it doesn't melt into liquid state. This melting process occurs at a definite temperature, right? So solid is heated, and this melting will occur at a very definite temperature. So the temperature at which the solid state start converting to liquid state, this temperature, this definite temperature, is called the melting point of the solid, right? At that temperature, this solid will start converting to liquid state. For example, the melting point of ice is 0 degrees Celsius. Below 0 degrees Celsius, this water is in solid form, that is in ice form. At 0 degrees Celsius, it start converting to liquid state, and more than 0 degrees Celsius, it will be liquid state. Water is in liquid state. So this is the melting point. And when liquid is heated to gaseous, they are not simply by heating the liquid, it doesn't start converting into gaseous state, right? So when at definite temperature the liquids start converting into gaseous state, this process is called the evaporation, liquid to gaseous, which is the evaporation process. When the temperature at which the liquid start converting to gaseous state, that temperature is called the boiling point of the liquid. For example, the boiling point of water is 100 degrees Celsius. At 100 degrees Celsius, the water starts converting to vapor form, gaseous form. The change of state of matter can be listed as it is. Solid, when it is heated, it will convert into liquid. This process is called melting, or also it is called fusion also. When liquid is heated, it will convert into gaseous. This process is called evaporation process or vaporization. When solid is heated, sometimes for some of the solids, it is possible that when this solid is heated, without getting the liquid state, this solid directly getting into gaseous state. Okay, so when solid is heated and if this convert into gaseous state, this process is called sublimation process. One example I can give, camphor is a sublime substance. When camphor is heated, it will directly convert into gaseous state. Okay, so by heating, now when gaseous is cooled, this process and it will convert into liquid state, this process is called condensation process. When liquid is cooled, it will convert into solid, this process is called solidification process. And when gaseous is cooled and directly we are getting the solid state, this reaction, this process will be called deposition process. So this is the whole process. Now, understand here, when liquid is converted into gaseous state, so during the vaporization process, let us say when water is heated, so the temperature rises in the thermometer, if we measure the temperature rises to normal temperature to 40 degree, 50 degree, 60. When the temperature reaches to 100 degree, the water is 100 degrees Celsius. So at this temperature, when the temperature reaches to 100 degrees Celsius, the water start converting to vapor. Okay, the boiling process starts. So the water start converting into vapor. Now at this, the heating is still going on, but the temperature in the thermometer is constant. Okay, so the question is where this heat is going. Okay, so this heat, the heat is going to convert the liquid into gaseous state. Okay, until the all the particles of the liquid convert into gaseous state, the heat will be utilized to convert, to change the state from liquid to gaseous. That's why the temperature in the thermometer is not changed. It is showing the 100 degrees Celsius only until the liquid convert into gaseous state. Okay, so this heat, the amount of heat utilized or used to convert to one state of the matter, convert liquid to gaseous state, this heat is called latent heat of vaporization. Okay, latent means hidden. Okay, this heat we are not able to see in the thermometer because it doesn't change the temperature in the thermometer. Okay, so the temperature doesn't change, but this heat will be utilized to convert liquid to, because this heat will be utilized to overcome the force between the particles. Then and then only, by this energy only, the liquid particle, the force will be weakens and the liquid particle will be going away from each other. Okay, so this heat, this energy will be utilized in separating the particles. Similarly, when solid is converting into liquid state, at the melting point the solid start converting to liquid state, but at that time the temperature becomes constant for a while and the amount, some amount of heat will be utilized to convert all the particles of solid to liquid. And so this heat, the amount of heat utilized to convert solid to liquid at the melting point, okay, this heat will be the latent heat of fusion. Okay, so this is the effect of temperature on the states of matter. Now, is there any other way to change the state of matter? By changing the temperature, we can change from one state to the other. But is there any other way to convert the states? Yes, by applying pressure. So what is the effect of pressure in the states of matter? See, when the gaseous state is pressurized, this by giving the pressure, the gaseous particles are coming closer to each other. So at some moment, this gaseous particles are that much close to each other that it will convert into liquid state. So by giving pressure, the gaseous state can be converted into liquid state. So this is the effect of pressure in the gaseous state. But when we apply pressure to liquid state, it doesn't change the liquid to solid, because the effect of pressure on the liquid state is negligible. Similarly, in solid also, the effect of pressure is negligible. It doesn't, no doubt, it changes the shape, but it doesn't change the state of the matter. So, the pressure effect is only seen in, significantly seen in gaseous state only. In liquid and solid, the pressure effect is negligible. So, students, read up to this, and if you have any doubts, you can ask me.